And on the line with us is Catherine Cirx, the president, founder of Square One Media Network and WomenVoteTrump.com. Her Twitter handle is at NewsBitch and at WomenForTrump. That's pushing the envelope, isn't it, Catherine? Welcome to the program.
Well, you know, that was my nickname in the newsroom, and I thought I'd go ahead and lead into it.
I see. I'm curious, are you a Republican?
No, I am not a Republican. I sometimes refer to myself as a conservatarian. I'm a fiscal conservative who is pro-choice and has served on the board of an LGBT group. So what does that make me?
Well, it seems like it would make you somebody who wouldn't support Donald Trump. Mike Pence is arguably one of the most aggressive attackers of the LGBT community in the United States. He passed just draconian legislation and argued for and lobbied very, very strongly for legislation that would give people in the state of Indiana the legal right to discriminate against gay people. And, you know, the whole periods for Pence thing where women are calling him up and saying, well, my period, has started again, so you don't have to worry about me, because he signed legislation that would force, that literally would put women in prison if they didn't have a funeral for a miscarriage. And, it's totally bizarre to me. How can you support a ticket like that with that kind of worldview?
Well, you know, people don't support a ticket because of the second person on the ticket. The support is for Trump.
But Trump is 70 years old.
He has picked his running mate. Well, what do you think he's gonna fall down
and wildly overweight?
He's not the one that seems to have health problems right now. So let's not get off into the vice president. Let's stay on the top of the ticket, because that's what everybody's interested in.
So you can focus on Trump and ignore the rest of the ticket.
That's not worth our time right now.
Okay. So Donald Trump is running as a Republican. The Republicans have pushed through literally every free trade deal that is on the books right now. Every single one came into law with the opposition of a majority of Democrats in both the House and the Senate, and with the support of a majority of Republicans, including NAFTA, which was negotiated under George Herbert Walker Bush. Even though Bill Clinton signed it, it was a Republican initiative. Donald Trump is opposed to those, so he's taking the Democratic position. On the other hand, Mike Pence has, and I realize you don't want to talk about Mike Pence, but Mike Pence and the entire Republican Party, and particularly Paul Ryan, have supported all of these free trade deals. Do you feel a little schizophrenic here?
Well, it is a very schizophrenic race, and the problem is, Tom, that, you know, labels don't work anymore. And I mean, a lot of people who probably listen to you who also probably think along the lines of what I think, which is maybe our two-party system isn't working so well for us after all, because we're locked into these two little boxes. And when you aren't quite inside the box, where do you end up?
But Donald Trump is a Republican. He's running as a Republican.
Well, he has to think, well, what is he going to do? He's going to run as a Democrat or Republican or stand on the sideline.
Well, he could do it, Ross Perot. Oop, we lost Catherine. She just vanished. I don't know if this was a Comcast hiccup or if it was her cell phone. It sounded like her cell phone was dying. Catherine, welcome back.
Sorry about that. What I was saying is, what's he going to do, stand on the sidelines? I mean, Ron Paul tried to run. He was as a libertarian. We all know that. And Ron Paul ran as a Republican so that he could get into the mainstream. So, you know, what's Republican and what's a Democrat at this point? I would venture to say that on both sides, that people agree with only part of the actual platforms of the party that they tend to follow.
Right. So you.
I don't know. What do you think? You from your side, do you think that do you think? I have a lot of progressive friends who aren't particularly happy with Hillary and don't feel that she's where they want her to be, but they support her.
Well, from my personal point of view, she's moved substantially in the direction of the policy positions that I hold, and I'm very pleased with that. But back to, you know, we're talking about Donald Trump and the Republican Party and your involvement with it, and, you know, running WomenVoteTrump.com, I'm guessing the revelation from Friday's tape would be disheartening to you. How do you, you know, I mean, here you have His only Senate supporter, Jeff Sessions, saying, you know, I mean, the reporter, I forget which reporter it was, but just explicitly asked Jeff Sessions, is not grabbing a woman's genitals sexual assault? And Jeff Sessions said, and I quote, I don't know. Oh, we just lost Catherine again. Okay, this is not working. Catherine, oops, hang on just a second here. Catherine, you're back with us. One of us has a flaky phone here.
Phone and see if this works better for us.
Okay. We just have a couple of minutes. I was, as I was pointing out, Jeff Sessions doesn't think or doesn't know if grabbing a woman that you don't even know by her genitals is sexual assault. How do you deal with that?
Let's talk about that, because of course I don't even like the language, but I do have kind of a foul mouth, so I am not as offended by it as say my mother, who, you know, doesn't like that at all.
He wasn't just cursing though, Catherine. He was bragging about committing sexual assault.
He talked about doing it.
He bragged about it.
And saying, did he actually do it? He said he didn't do it.
But there are numerous women who have come forward and said, yes, he did.
And assaulted him?
Yes, you got Gloria Allred is like has got a list. I think it's over a dozen now. There's several women who have been on the record saying this for quite some time now.
Okay, here's my question. Here's what I come back to, and it's a question for you. And I'm really not saying this for trying to throw dirt, but I don't understand why the behavior of Bill Clinton in office is acceptable behavior for a president, but then what Trump says is not acceptable behavior. That's not trying to defend him. I just don't get it.
Sure. Okay. Well, let me answer your question. I'd be glad to answer your question. What Bill Clinton did was consensual sex between two consenting adults. And what Donald Trump is bragging about doing is non-consensual sexual violence.
Kathleen Wiley says he attacked her in the White House.
Okay, well, litigate it. Litigate it. But Bill Clinton is not bragging about this. Bill Clinton is not saying, I am the role model for your children. Bill Clinton is not saying, this is cool. Bill Clinton has never said any of that stuff. In fact, Bill Clinton has been contrite and has apologized.
By running for president, he set himself up as a role model. Now, how is that different? I don't get it.
I would say that the lesson that young people got out of the Clinton presidency and the Clinton impeachment, and by the way, Bill Clinton's not running for president, but, you know, I understand the rationale. It's like,
the question is the moral equivalence of
well, it's not a moral equivalence. It's they're apples and oranges, because the message that young people in particular, this is, you know, I think the concern of many people is, you know, what kind of message is this sending to young boys? The message of the Bill Clinton presidency was, don't do that. If you get caught, there's going to be terrible consequences. People are going to be hurt. Your family is going to be damaged. Your reputation is going to be destroyed, and you may lose your job. That was the message that I think young people got out of Bill Clinton having an affair.
He didn't lose his job. His approval numbers in the party actually went up afterwards.
Because of the way the Republicans behaved. Because Ken Starr tried to turn consensual sex into pornography. But Bill Clinton's not on the ticket.
But you have not made the case for why that's okay for Bill Clinton.
Well, no, Catherine, you know, the counter argument to what you're saying is, you know, is it all right that Donald Trump's third wife posed nude for a magazine? I mean, you know, it's like if you're going to go after the spouse of somebody who's running for political office, then or is it appropriate that his second wife was having an affair with him with his first wife there? I mean, you know, and he brought them both along on this trip to Colorado. I mean, it's presidential spouses. It's a completely different thing. Is it not?
It's not a completely different thing. I'm not talking about Bill Clinton as a presidential spouse. I'm talking about him as president.
But his presidency has been over for what?
But it was acceptable
16 years
for him,
longer
but not
than that?
Acceptable for Trump. So I mean,
no,
Bill Clinton opponents have come out with.
Bill Clinton never bragged about sex.
If you want to move on and talk about some more, okay. That's okay. But
Catherine, we're out of time. But thanks for dropping by. WomenVoteTrump.com is the website. Women at Trump.
This is the Tom Hartman Program.